Welcome to the first episode of Bake Dance, where we'll be making recipes baked in the oven, whether savory or sweet, accompanied by songs that I love and inspire me. So today we're going to be making one of my grandmother's recipes. It's called Pastourma Pie, which in English is pie with pastourma. Now pastourma is what we have here, which is a cured meat, usually beef, but it can also be camel, or actually it's made, depending on the country, different kinds of beef. But the trick, what really makes a pastourma, is the coating that it's cured in. And I really wish that you could smell it, because it's a very, very potent smell. It's a combination of paprika, hence the red, garlic, tzimeni, which is the cumin, and fenugreek, which is really what makes it, the smell so potent. And what we're gonna do before we prepare it for our pie is take away the coating, because otherwise that smell is gonna be pouring out of your pores. And we'll take it all off all the way around. And then if you want, just to add a little bit of flavor later on when we start putting the layers on our pie, save the tzimeni because you might want to sprinkle just a little bit for a little extra flavor. So don't throw it away. After we've cleaned the pastourma from the coating, and like I said, we've saved some of the coating aside because you might sprinkle it later for a little bit of extra spice. Then we're gonna melt our butter so that we can coat our pan before we put the phyllo dough. So just don't be stingy. Take a big chunk of butter and melt it. While that butter's melting, then we can open up our packet of phyllo. So now for this pie, you can use any kind of dough. I'm feeling a little lazy today and I'm not making my own dough and I bought ready-made. So my grandmother would kill me if I was not making my own dough. This is really just as good, I promise. I'm gonna get, there should be two pieces in here, yep. And one we're gonna layer on the bottom, and one we're gonna layer on the top. But before we layer the bottom, we're gonna have to coat our pan so it doesn't stick. Nothing like the smell of melted butter, huh? Now this, the kourou, is a little bit of the thicker dough that people normally bake with this kind, but personally I like it. Be very gentle with the dough so it doesn't break. Treat it with love.